there you see the Midnight Express. They are truly the rightful owners of the United States Tag Team Belt. I don't know why they don't have them around their waist. Maybe that Flying Brian and Z-Man may have took them and hit them or something.
Well, that's why they have horse races, Teddy. Difference of opinion, and obviously their powers that be don't agree with you. The bell sound.
Okay.
Robert Gibson.
Okay, you see Robert Gibson there. He's the legal guy in the ring there. He starts off with beautiful Bobby Eaton here, and we ought to have a good confrontation going on here.
Beautiful Bobby. Collar and elbow tie-up with Robert Gibson. They call him Hoot Gibson after the old star. Well, referee Nick Patrick trying to get him out of the corner, and look at Robert go.
Well, now you see Robert Gibson already getting in the ring there, breaking the rules, balling up the fist there. Now he needs to keep that hand open. If I was a referee, I'd disqualify him immediately. I wouldn't put up with it.
He may have balled it up, but I tell you, he didn't do like somebody that I know by the name of Doom, and that is use it. All he did was take him and marry him over with a couple of side shots that were beautiful and took him over and down. Beautiful Bobby. Robert Gibson tied up once again.
He's got my arm, I'm kicking.
See now, beautiful Bobby is trying to get
look at that.
That's an open hand. That's an open hand, Lance Russell. I'm looking right at it.
The referees happen to be a little bit closer than you are, Teddy, and he told him to come out of the corner and open the hand up. So he obviously hit him with a fist. Going in the air, that flying head scissors takes Bobby Eaton over. There's a tag on to Ricky Morton. Morton right away, he's at work. Look at these guys go.
Well, I tell you something right now, they're rock and roll. They're the hottest team right now in the NWA. You better believe that, but I tell you what, they haven't got a chance to get in the room with Doom, brother. We'll cool them off.
Yeah, I'd kind of like to see that. No question Doom would have the size, but the speed, I would have to tip my hat to the Rock and Roll Express.
Well, speaking about good teams, now let's not count the Midnight Express out. Now they're out there with the tutelage of James Cornette, and brother, I tell you, Rock and Roll's got their hands full with them too now.
And particularly when they've got the Louisville Lip, Jimmy Cornette, and that loaded tennis racket down in ring.
Not the Louisville Lip, he's the Louisville Slugger.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah.
That tag goes right back to Robert Gibson, turning the arm over as he hooks the wrist on Stan Lane. Lane backs him up into the turnbuckle, shoots that right hand and drills him. Robin reverses it. Now that was an open hand.
No, it was not.
He slapped him upside the face.
No, it was not. That was a closed fist. Okay, I'm looking at it. Boss, let me tell you something, Lance Russell. You need to get your glasses changed, or either you need to borrow mine.
You didn't see the referee coming up to make any comment. He saw it was an open hand when he popped him. They're back to the center of the ring, circling it and tie it up. Robert to a standing side headlock. Stan moves him into the rope. Over the top goes Gibson. He shot him with that side kick of his.
Now that's the specialty of Sweet Stan Lane. He knows how to give you that super kick, brother, and I tell you, once he puts that kick on you, brother, you're gonna go down.
Lane, of course, with a karate background, catches. Right in the back of the head from Robert Gibson. Covers 1, 2. That's all he can do.
Well, there you see Robert Gibson breaking the rules again. Goes over and hits beautiful Bobby. Bobby's not even a legal man in the ring. He had no business touching him. That's the way the rock and roll are.
He had no business messing in with what the action was at that moment. Tag goes to Ricky Morton. Ricky now will be squaring off with Sweet Stan unless he tags it out to Bobby Eaton. As the crowd picks up the chant, rock and roll. They love him.
Well, right now, if I was Sweet Stan, right, I'd try to do is make the tag. The beautiful Bobby Eaton over there. Bobby Eaton said, well, now Stan's using his head. He's made the tag. Bobby Eaton's in there.
Advice.
There you see Ricky Morton. He's got beautiful Bobby. Well, he shoots him out of the corner there. Goes in. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, yeah. I don't blame Sweet Stan because what Ricky Morton was going to do right there, you had him in a flying head scissors and he was choking the guy. I don't blame Stan.
He was going to take him over, and unfortunately, Robert had done that a little bit earlier, and you went to the well too many times, and he caught him, dropped him right over the rope, and now it's Morton thrown in, up in the air, and bounces with the momentum off the rope, and Bobby drops him with a back fake breaker across that knee. A beautiful maneuver. You got to give him credit for that.
Well, you can hear the fans right now who chant rock and roll, but that ain't going to help rock and roll because if he takes any more of those backbreakers, well, that's beautiful Bobby making the tag to Sweet Stan. Now, all Stan has to do is get in and capitalize on what beautiful Bobby's already done, work on the back of Ricky Morton. out of action, baby.
Sweet stick.
Big power slam.
360 power. Gets a count, but no more. And now he's complaining to the referee he didn't count fast enough. What's he want?
Well, I don't blame him. These referees in the NWA now are so incompetent, I don't know what's wrong with him.
Yeah. Are you referring to the fact that since Teddy Long is no longer refereeing, there's no other good referees?
I was the best referee that the NWA ever had, and since they left, since I quit refereeing and I found a better job, then the NWA referees are just incompetent. That's all I got to say.
Well, evidently somebody didn't agree with you on that. Beautiful bomb. But that front face lock, he's going to take him up. He does. Turns him in the air.
What a move, Lance Russell. Now, Bobby Eaton, now BB should have him right there. Y'all to cover him.
One, two, and he couldn't get it. Only two.
I don't know how Ricky Morton kicked out of that, brother. He must be working on guts alone.
Eaton puts that corkscrew suplex on you, and it is a dandy because it leaves you in a mode of disorientation. Chop to the midsection.
That was not a chop now. That was an open hand.
Oh, sure. He patted him on the tummy.
Of course.
Yeah.
Stan Lane never breaks the rules.
He got him with a cross. He got him with that double clutch cross in there. Stands down with a foot on the throat.
Now, you see the Midnight Express, how congenial they are. They make the tag at the right time. They don't let each other wear down. You know, they know what they're doing, brother. They're ring veterans.
Double chicken wing, and he takes him over and down. Hooks the leg. One, two, oh, boy. Just that close to having the three count. But referee Nick Patrick signifying only two.
Well, I got to give it to the Rock and Roll Express, especially to Ricky Morton, brother, because he's been right there. I thought he'd been counted out a long time ago. So evidently, he's fighting on instinct alone. He doesn't even really know where he is right now. But, brother, he's got good. Look at him go.
You got that right. Beautiful Bobby trying to put the killer on him. Goes to the eyes. That's a killer, all right. Refuge of the coward, we have often said, as he raked the eyes right there on Ricky Morton while Stan comes in. And look at that. Now, there's no place in that.
Well, no place in what? The only wrestling? What are you talking about, Lance Russell?
Going on. He takes him over and down.
Now, let me tell you something. The referee has no business over there bothering Cornette. He called Cornette to jump up on the apron. The referee did. I was looking right at him. Now, what's he want with Cornette?
Oh, he caused Cornette to jump up.
Yeah, I heard him. He said, come here, Kimmy, get up here.
Sure he did. Well, I'm telling you, this is one time I'm glad that he was over there as he missed any kind of a count. We've got beautiful Bobby again. Is he going? No. It's reversed and taking Eaton over and down in a suplex.
I got to say something again too, Lance Russell. Bad as I hate to, this Ricky Morton is really impressing me here today, and everybody's watching this match. I'm sure he's impressing them too. Oh, wait a minute. Look at that referee.
Against the Midnight Express, and Jimmy Cornette gives a hand over to Bobby, who makes the tag on Stan. There's the tag on Robert, and here we go. Shot to the midsection, drives the head down into the mat.
Well, one thing about referee Nick Patrick, if he ever loses his referee license, he can get a job working for the Atlanta Hawks, buddy, because he's really high in the air then.
He did, in fact, climb out of the way in a big hurry as Ricky is in, Robert is in. We've got all four of them inside the ring now. Stan back up in the corner. What's this? Cornette. Robert busts Jimmy Cornette. Shoved off into the rope. Shoulder in there, and they're both down. It's a double knockdown.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. What's this here?
Yeah, what is it?
That's a Freebird. Hey!
The victory for them, and they caused them to lose.
Well, let's look at the replay here. Now, here you see the replay. Here's Jimmy Cornette with that tennis racket. Robert Gibson ducks out of the way. He nails beautiful Bobby. Right here you see Robert Gibson gets beautiful Bobby in a headlock right there. Here he goes. knocked him right down. They're both down.
And keep your eye on what happens in the ring.
Nothing's happening. Robert Gibson's trying to get up.
Look at this. Look at this.
Well,
no business being in.
Well, Jimmy Jam come down because Jimmy Cornette is down outside there. So Jimmy Jam and Michael Hayes come down to help out the Midnight Express.
Michael Hayes and Jimmy Jam cause the Rock and Roll a loss. Final words for you in a moment.